morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody. This is another day that our great God has made. Can we praise God for that right now? Can we praise God for waking us up this morning? Can we praise God for starting us on our way? Can we praise God? God has been too good. God has been too good. We ought to give God an alive praise this morning. We ought to give God an alive praise this morning. God, you've been so good. I will praise you. I will worship you. I will magnify you because you reign forever. You reign supreme. Nobody is standing on the throne but you, God. Hallelujah. We're going to start praising and worshiping. He reigns forever. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Since he raised them, we ought to continue to praise God.
Hallelujah.
We ought to continue to praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise and worship God. We're going to continue to praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Just want to praise you.
Thank you, Lord.
verse 2.
Free. law and the prophets. Glory be to the Father.
Thank you. Come on. just got to let you know. Stuff was tough before COVID showed up. God has continued to be good to us. Good to our mothers and our fathers, our ancestors. God has just been good to us. We ought not ever forget that. This ain't the first plague, and it certainly won't be the last. But I tell you one thing, but yet will we praise the Lord.
Verse,
whoever is not against us is for us. Last verse 4, truly I tell you. You know when Jesus started talking about the truth. That's one of them, you can take that to the bank.
That means something about to go down right here now. That's kind of like, look, as sure as I'm standing here, as sure as the day is long, you can put some money down, you can call up your bookie. This is a sure thing, baby.
All right.
For truly I tell you,
True. Whoever
gives you a cup of water to drink because you bear the name of Christ will by no means lose the reward. I want to try to talk for a few minutes about all for one.
Well,
and one for all.
Well, all right.
I know we know that from the Three Musketeers. All for one and one for all. But there was a fourth musketeer where this saying comes into play, amen. But I know that we know of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. We know of the three Hebrew boys and the fiery furnace, but when the king looked in there, he saw another one. And I'm telling you, we only gather together because there's all of us need to be about that one. One, the one Son, the only begotten Son of God, Jesus the Christ, who in turn is that when we call upon that great name, Jesus, who is no respecter of person, while he's all for one, he's a one for all of us. All of us, for all of us, that needs to be the only one. And so as we near the close of another conference year, this is a good time to reflect on how good God has been to us. Oh, God has been good to us.
Yeah.
Oh, God been better to us, some people might say, during the pandemic than before the pandemic. God has blessed us to be able to do more with less. God has blessed us with having fewer people in the pews, but more people online. God has blessed us, amen. Folk that weren't giving before are giving now. God has blessed us. We have figured out how to have parties and how to have celebrations, amen. Physically distant. We have figured out how to safely gather with one another and continue to lift up the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Yes. God has kept the doors of the church open. Yes, God has kept the power on. Oh, I'm not talking about what Amarin sends to the building. I'm talking about Holy Ghost power. God has continued to shower down his power from on high. Oh, as we close out this conference year, that means that congregations are preparing reports. They're getting ready to give updates on their BHAGs, their big, hairy, audacious goals, amen, that Bishop Few tasked us with. There'll be talk about lead churches and mother churches and rural churches versus urban churches. I just stopped by to tell you that seems to be similar to the conversation that the disciples were having. Whose name will be great? More so than anybody else. Oh, my son is to tell me, Dad, they sure call your name a lot. I say, son, that's not a good thing. That's why you don't see me as much. That's why I'm as tired as much. Just because they call your name, that don't mean you're doing good. This text is about doing things in the name of the Lord. Yes, they were talking about who would be great amongst them. But Jesus is teaching them what was really going on. Because here they are, example after example. They just didn't get it.
Well,
Jesus says, I'm going to
who's going to take over. Jesus is telling you that whoever is not against us is for us.
Amen.
But here they are, stopping people from casting out demons in the name of the Lord. Yes, like us.
Yeah.
The disciples ain't get it right quite often. But God continued to teach them. This text is about discipleship. Discipleship. That's what Jesus was teaching them. He had gathered a little baby to them and said, unless you come to me like one of these, not as a little child, but as one tender and young in the faith, that the first shall be last and the last shall be first. He is teaching them about discipleship. When Jesus called the disciples, he started out about discipleship. So this text talking about discipleship, not membership, discipleship. The two are different. It's premature to talk about leadership. You ain't been here long enough. You ain't been in the Word long enough. You ain't been fasting and praying long enough. You got to get to discipleship first.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Discipleship is how Jesus started his ministry. Discipleship is where we see the patience, the care, and the love as he taught his disciples how to be disciples. Discipleship. It happens first and foremost by one way. Teaching. The only way you're going to be all for one and one for all, you got to be taught how to do that thing. You got to be taught how to be one. To be one in the Spirit and to be one in the Lord and to be on one accord and to be on one baptism, one faith, one God, that one. The power that only comes from God. You don't get there by yourself. This is not a weekend. Self-improvement. Doing yourself project. You can't go to a workshop and become a disciple overnight. Oh, it don't work that way. You gotta go through some stuff. You gotta fail sometimes. You gotta fall sometimes. You gotta get dirty sometimes. You gotta just be wrong sometimes. You gotta go through something in order to be a disciple. That's Jesus says here. An issue. They were admonishing someone because he was casting out demons in the name of the Lord. Now, ain't that something? He didn't grow up around here. He wasn't Naomi. She wasn't in the WMS. They didn't know the difference between the discipline of the Bible. But God, Jesus is saying, don't you stop there. You see, because the word thing, he said, do it in the name. I'm not talking about just saying the words in the name of Jesus. You see, using those words is not some incantation. It is not some magical spell. It is not some magic formula. It's not those words as much as it is what's behind those words. In financials, they got a promissory note. You can give anybody a piece of paper, but if there's something to back it up, amen. When we call on the name of Jesus, on the promises of Jesus. We are in the salvation of Jesus. We are the children of the Most High God. And we know one thing is for sure. God can back up what it's saying. Because God can do anything but fail. Say it.
You
see, they was caught up on whose name was going to be used. When it was going to be their name. I don't care. care if your name is above the door. They can name a room after you. They can name a wing after you. They can name the whole school after you. That don't mean there's no power in your name. It's what's behind it. My brothers and my sisters, as we go forth preparing our reports, as we go forth going running to proclaim how good God has been to us, let us always be reminded that this is all for one and one for all, and the one is Christ Jesus, and we are the one body of Christ. And don't let the fact that somebody do something different than you, don't let your faith, don't let your church spite your faith. I know you heard it. Don't let your nose spite your face. But don't you let your church spite your faith. Because this is about faith in God. This is about this man, whoever he was. He didn't know what they, he didn't come from where they come from. But I got news for you. God might have told you everything that you know, but God didn't tell you everything that God knows. Because we can't even handle that. What you talking about, Pastor? This is nothing new. Way back in Numbers, amen, when the 70 elders were appointed and Moses was there and the glory of God came and poured down his spirit, amen, on the 70, and they began to prophesy one time. There were a couple of other guys that didn't even make the meeting. Eldad and Medad. Read it in Numbers 11. They got to prophesy. Everybody else was out of the camp. And they in the camp prophesying. And Joshua ran to Moses. They are prophesying. Amen. And they weren't at the meeting. They weren't there when the glory of the Lord came, fell down. Moses said, leave it alone. God blesses who God wants to bless. Just because you don't like them, God, the anointing, can fall on anybody. Don't you get caught up because your name ain't on it. It's the name of the Lord, and every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Say it. Don't let us get too high and mighty. Don't let us get too high and mighty on ourselves. Preachers, don't you think you all that in the bag of chips? Humble ourselves before the power of Almighty God. But look at this. I rushed off too quickly. Who's doing this? John, the beloved disciple. John. He's the one. This is not Peter saying, Lord, this is John. The one whom Jesus loved. It don't matter what position you have. We all can fall prey to this temptation, this jealousy, this competitiveness. It gets at us sometimes. But we gotta do as Jesus told them. Don't you stop anybody that's doing something in the name of the Lord. You may not like what you hear. Their experience may not have been your experience, but let it go forth. I'm gonna tell you something to save yourself, amen, before you wreck yourself, amen. Because when you can fool around calling on the name of Jesus, but you keep on calling it. Watch and see, don't something happen. You can't play with the power of God. God will show up. God will have his way. God will hear his calling. Hear our plea. And just because somebody talk funny, they didn't walk
just trying to teach the disciples.
Teach them.
You don't get caught up in this mess. Because it's a whole lot of mess to get caught up in.
Yes, yes, yes.
People preach for all kinds of reasons. Paul says it in Philippians 1 and 15 through 18. Some people only preach to discredit him, to embarrass him, to prove him wrong. But Paul said, don't you worry about that. Because you get to fooling around with the word of God that is powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. That's why they say when you go to do some wrong to somebody, you're going to dig a ditch for somebody, you might as well dig too. Because you wind up falling in it right along with them. Because God's word accomplishes that which he intends and does not return to him. No. But then, my brothers and my sisters, we got this straight about doing it in his name. Because we got some wars going on sometimes. Pastor, you baptized them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. You didn't put in Jesus' name in there. Got people walking around think they ain't baptized now. It's what's behind it. It's the power of God. That's why we ought to study to show ourselves approved, rightly dividing the word of truth, which is the word of God.
That's right.
Not to control, not to manipulate, but to set the captives free. That's what Jesus came to do. He that the Son has set free is free indeed. But then lastly, my brothers and my sisters, if we're going to be all for one, one fall, the thing you got to master is that you keep on serving.
Amen.
Service. When we talk about discipleship, that's what we're talking about. We're talking about service. We got to talk about continuing to serve. And folk are serving in all kinds of places. Some folk are in prison, but they still serve. Some people are working the corner, but they still serve. Some people are causing all kinds of struggles and chaos and grief, but sometimes they still, if you just keep on serving. I'm not talking about being in the service. Serving is an action word. Just as teaching is an action word. There is some action. Faith cometh by hearing. The word of God, that's where the teaching comes by. But our works alone are not good enough for us.
Amen.
We need them both. So when we serve, that's what's characteristic of a disciple. Serving. Serving in the name of the Lord. Serve. You not knowing how this thing is going to work out, but you keep on serving. If I could tell you the number of Tuesday afternoons, Tuesday mornings, that Brother Ed and Sister Earlene and I wrestled over how these finances were going to end up positively in the black when we're trying to figure out who was going to get paid and who was not going to get paid and how we were going to send it just in time so that things didn't get cut off. If I could just share with you the amount of times that happened, but I can tell you one thing that I always knew. I didn't know how God was going to do it, but I knew that God was going to do it. Because God said it, amen, and now to be able to sit, amen, week after week, amen, it didn't happen before the serving food. We started delivering food. We started unloading.
You see, that's what we got to do. Mm-hmm. We got to teach our disciples. Mm-hmm. Get off these young people's backs. Because they're doing some things differently. They're trying to gather in some different ways. They got some good reason not to come up in some churches. Now, ain't nothing against the folk that are here or the folk that are in those churches. But when you search and when you seek, we got generations of folk that grew up. You didn't ask no questions. You just did what you were told to do.
I know.
And then we raise our children to ask questions, to be critical thinkers. And then we don't know how to answer them when they start asking critical questions. Because we didn't do enough in discipleship.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
So while God is working that thing out, you just keep on serving. You keep on loving. You keep on opening the doors of the church. You keep on giving your tithes and your offerings that have ministries go forth from the church. And so when they start asking questions, maybe they don't go to the home church, but maybe they'll try your church because you look like you're doing what the church ought to do, which is serving the people. That's why we serve God. That's why we love God with all our heart, all our soul, and all our mind. That's why we serve God. That's why Joshua said, in the beginning he didn't have it right. He wasn't told on them. He snitched on them. But then in the end, it was Joshua that said, choose you this day whom you will serve. And that's what we got to do, my brothers and sisters. We ought to keep serving God. We serve God. Whether we got 5 people or 5,000 people, whether we got COVID-19 or COVID-29, we keep serving God. Whether you got money in the bank or you trying to make ends meet, you keep serving God. I'm telling you, if you serve God, amen, just like the offertory song says, you can't beat God's giving. The more you give, the more you try, the harder you give. You can't beat God's giving. End up this conference, how good God has been. We got some folk that don't want to take the vaccine. We got some folk that can't take the vaccine. But I know one thing is for sure, that God will make a way somehow. We sitting up there fighting about that stuff. We ought to not stop those that are moving forward and working in the name of the Lord. Not just saying names, but you will know them by the fruit that they bear. We keep on serving. Serve, and the fruit will go forth. And God will prosper us. And God will return unto us 10-fold, 100-fold, 1,000-fold. Yeah. Beyond that which you could imagine. The key here is in the name of Jesus. There is power. That's the difference from saying the name and knowing the name. When you know the name, that's when the every knee bows, every tongue confesses, because you are talking, amen, about what God has done for you, what he's done for others, he'll do for you. You just keep on serving God. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the sun, you just keep on serving God. Serve God and watch God make a way. Serve God. Watch God turn some lives around. Serve God. Watch God. Watch God open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you won't have room enough to receive. That's it. As you serve God.
To break and change.
you'll break loose. That's it.
Break every chain.
The doors of the church are open.
There is power.
Yes.
In the name.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Yes. God promised to break the chains. God promised to set the captives free. So God, we thank you, Lord, for those that you set free. Oh God, we thank you for the new day that is in your son Jesus. Oh God, we thank you for those that came to this telecast one way, but they left, Lord, stronger than when they came. They left, Lord, new creatures in Christ. They left, Lord, with a new song in their heart. So God, we just thank you, Lord, for how you have continued to do what you do, God. So we thank you for the chains that are broken. We thank you, God, that you move them away from us, that you cast them aside, that we never take them up again, God, that we walk in your power and your might, but most of all in your name, which means to be in your will, says the Lord. And Father, we just thank you for those that have been set free. And we will continue to praise you and to give you all the glory, honor, that is due you. In Jesus' name we pray. And it's not robbery to thank God for how God has blessed us. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God. Amen. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Just thank God. Because it is in the name of that name. That name. Jesus the Christ. Thank God. Amen.
Thank you.
Go to our offering. We just want to thank God. Amen. One more time. Amen. As we thank God with our gifts that God has given unto us, and we give back unto God. We thank God for how he has continued to bless us and to continue to do the work. Amen. God has certainly been good. God has loved us in a very tangible way. Amen. Has allowed us to move forward. And so we thank God for that. And we thank God for those that have participated in our family and friends celebration. We thank God that we have an anonymous donor that has given on behalf of all of our children. Amen. Has donated $10 on behalf of all of our children. Amen. Our participation number is up to over 40% now. And now we are at about 82-83% of our goal. Amen. We have exceeded last year's goal. God is good. Amen. We are within $3,000. Amen. Of meeting our stretch goal. Amen. God is good. Amen. So when you just continue to trust God. Amen. Now that we're getting God's house in order, we're going to be working on making sure that your financial house is in order. God don't get folk free so that they can just be free. God frees folk so they can free others. Amen. So we thank God as we work on being disciples, being witnesses, and being examples of God's grace, mercy, and love. Amen. Forgotten how to give online. Go to Givelify. You'll find St. James, S-A-I-N-T, James, St. Louis. And you can use the app just like an envelope. Amen. Your tithes, your offering, your family, your friends. If you still want to give on behalf of Haiti, you can do that as well. And then for those that like to use the old reliable U.S. Postal Service, you can drop it in the mail and it will get delivered to the blood-stained door at 4301 St. Ferdinand Avenue, amen, St. Louis, Missouri, area code 63113. We thank God for your gifts. And we also want to thank God with our offertory, because we know all things come of the Lord.
Yeah.
Commission, amen. We have a word from Bishop Hugh, and we have some news that we will be having more in-person services, amen, for those that are comfortable to do so in the coming week. So you'll hear more about it very soon, amen. But in the meantime, we want to thank our wonderful praise team, amen, for them leading us in praise and worship, amen. We want to thank, amen, our support staff, amen, Brother Anthony and Sister Brenda and Sister Roz, amen, as temperatures are taken, and our stewardess on duty, and our steward on duty with Brother Ed and Sister Mildred and our evangelist Kathy that helped me out in the pulpit, amen. But we want to thank each and every one of you, amen, for tuning in, for praising with us, for lifting up the name of Jesus, and most of all, praying for one another, because it's the fervent, effectual prayer of the righteous that availeth much. Because we're doing it in the name, and we know what's behind the name. Jesus the Christ, amen, that heals us, delivers us, leads and guides us, and lifts us. And now for our doxology and benediction. Praise God from whom all blessings flow.
God bless you. God keep you. Only 2 more weeks of the conference here. Bye-bye.